afternoon and welcome to the Christmas concert. We're going to start off the program with a third grade chorus, and we're glad you're here, and sit back and enjoy the concert.
Ho, ho, ho! this little group together, sort of a little pickup group for this concert, and we sort of caught a few rehearsals in the wee hours of the morning, and we're going to play now Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow.
Oh,
exclamation point, exclamation point.
Thank you.
Kwanzaa, and John Glode's going to explain a little bit about what Kwanzaa means.
Kwanzaa is an African-American holiday that honors black people and their history. It was created in 1966 by Dr. Malana Karinga to remind his people of their African beginnings. In creating it, he hoped to fashion a celebration that would teach history as it explored values and traditions that were important to the African-American people. Celebration is rich in symbols that help reinforce these values and traditions. Each of the 7 days of Kwanzaa has its own theme. With the lighting of the candle for that day, everyone has a special idea to think about during the celebration. As that candle is lit, someone in the room explains the principle or belief that the day represents. There are often stories to help explain the concept to everyone. The 7 days represent day one, Umoja, unity. Day two, Kujichagulia, self-determination. Day three, Ujima, collective work and responsibility. Day four, Ujima, cooperative economics. Day five, Nia, purpose. Day six, Kumba, creativity. Day seven, Imani, faith.
Memories of Babes in Arms, I think. Thank you.
Thank you.
for the concert band and wind ensemble to regroup, and while we're waiting, the third grade chorus, we were saying earlier, was our first group, and the elementary chorus, they sing in chorus one time a week for half an hour. They give up their playground time, and they come because I think they really want to be there, which is 90% of the reason why they're so great, and it just always amazes me that they only come one half an hour a week. I just thought you'd like to know that if you didn't already know.
That's one of my favorites. That's just a great arrangement of that folk song. Before we play our second number, the concert, Mrs. Runnels and I would like to just thank Mr. O'Connor and Mrs. Carr for helping put this together, and to the PTO for helping organize some refreshments. And we'd like to recognize the sixth graders who came in and did the little decorations along the sides. And we'd like to thank Tim Carr, who went out in the woods with his saw and brought us a beautiful tree. And we'd also like to thank the students who helped to decorate and put up lights. And I'd like to announce the winners of the Greater Clinton County Drum Set Decorating Contest are Tim Mulligan and Merritt Billiter. Thank the ladies who decorated my podium. I don't know whether to conduct the band or balance a ball on my nose. But to all the people who helped to make this such a special event, and to you all for coming and sharing it with us. We're going to play one more tune, and then the band and the chorus, and then some of you who are going to join us for the Hallelujah chorus, start thinking about it.
Thank you. To holy girl and dad.
I guess I'm elected to do the coaxing here. Every year we debate, should we do the hallelujah chorus, should we not do the hallelujah chorus, and we like to do it. So if any of you are inclined to sing, don't all rush the stage at once. By the way, Santa will be available after the concert for some treats for the little ones, and maybe some photo ops there. All right, there we go.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
I have some extra hallelujah copies, too, if anybody needs them.
Okay, I think the ties of peer pressure are coming our direction. Mrs. Devins, I see you, Mrs. Devins. Mr. Arthur, I had told you, sing. Thank you. sing along with us.
Thank you. It may look like we're in the middle of a noisy study hall, but we're at beautiful downtown Pickett's Corners. It's the 20th day of December, 1994. And we're here for the first game of the 1994-95 Modified A basketball season, featuring the Northeastern Clinton Cougars and the home team, the Saranac Central Chiefs. Very quickly, for the Chiefs, Katie Liberty, number 5, Megan Kent, number 10, Nicole Reef, number 14, Katie Warner, 15, Jessica Flick, 20, Jamie Pelkey, 21, Rita Clifford, 22, Jenny Rael is number 23, Amanda Martin is 24, Trish Triller is 25, Sarah Bennett is number 31, Nicole Perry is number 32, and Jenna Fuller is number 33, Missy Dar, 34, and Chrissy Muller is number 35. Cougars missed the opening layup, and the Chiefs bring it back. Give you Northeastern's lineup in just a moment. Shot is too strong, rebounded by Debbie Trombley. She gives it to Marie Boris. Over to Ashley Walter. And the Cougars turn it over. Quickly for the Cougars, Carmen Diesel, Ashley Walter, Amber Bohannon, Tara Dragoon, Megan Miller, Debbie Trombley, Marie Boris, Dana Brassard, Melissa Yell, Brandy Sample, Angel Dapol, Nicole Tardif, Michelle Brown, Nicole Levantre, and Erin St. Hilaire. Off Boris, it'll be white ball again. St. Hilaire providing the defense. Ball comes in for the Chiefs. This is Clifford. Flick puts it up, too strong. Clifford controls. Seventh grader Walter inbounds to Boris, and Boris will bring it up the floor. All the way through. Like a hot knife through butter. Marie Boris slices right through the Chiefs. Comes up with the steal. And Chiefs are going to control it. Coach for the Cougars, of course, is Brian Power. The coach for the Chiefs is Steve LePage. St. Hilaire gives to Boris. Up ahead for Walter. Ashley Walter up off the glass. Walter gets her own rebound.